Hello everybody, my name is Luke Marr and this is Hot La Mode, and today on Hot La Mode we are going to be reacting to the Page Six article that says that Anna Wintour is leaving Vogue. Now, before we get into the actual video, if you guys are looking for a channel that talks about fashion in the most fun, sassy, bitchy, critical way, this is it. So you can go down below, hit the subscribe button, and also turn on my post notifications. What do you have to lose? Also, if you like these kinds of reacting to article videos, definitely give it a thumbs up. And also, you can follow me on Instagram if you want to see more from me. Intro done in 20 seconds, that is a record. But yes, we are going to be talking about this article. It is salacious, it is rumors, it is gossip, it is everything that fashion is, and I'm so happy that it came out because I have something to talk about. So, Anna is apparently leaving Vogue according to Page Six. As you probably know, fashion rumors are quite abhorrent and happen a lot, but they also usually are true, even though they're like 5 or 6 years in advance. CC, Phoebe Philo leaving Celine. So obviously I'm going to read the article and then I'll give my little tidbits about what I think about each paragraph or sector of the article, so don't worry. It is almost beyond the fashion world's wildest imagination, but the chatter coming out of Condé Nast and the publishing industry has reached a deafening crescendo. Anna Wintour could be on her way out of Condé and Vogue as artistic director. Does that mean that she's gonna be leaving Vogue as editor-in-chief? Like, that's not what that says. It just says artistic director, and she has been the artistic director of a majority of the Condé publications, so she might stay at Vogue, you never know. A host of stunned sources have told Page Six that Wintour, the grand high priestess of both the fashion and publishing industries since she became editor-in-chief of Vogue in 1988, is to exit her all-powerful role at the publishing house this summer after the July wedding of her daughter, B. Schaefer, to Francesco Carazzini, the son of former Italian Vogue editor Franca Zozzani. The move would also allow Wintour, 68, who has for 3 decades been fashion's ultimate power broker, to step aside on a high after closing Vogue's all-important September issue. Let me just say, I think this is so smart of Anna, and if she does this, I think it's brilliant. If she is to stay and the publishing industry continues to go down and just get destroyed, which it will, she's gonna look awful and it's gonna ruin her reputation. I think that this is honestly such a smart move for her and it's something that she should be doing. But Condé Nast strongly denies Wintour is going. A Condé corporate spokesperson told Page Six on Monday, "We emphatically deny these rumors, but declined to comment more specifically on Wintour's plans. However, we're told Vogue UK's editor, Edward Enninful, is the likely replacement as the editor of US Vogue. It's unclear who, if anyone, might replace Wintour as the artistic director of Condé Nast, the title she ascended to in 2013, giving her oversight over all Condé magazine titles. Honestly, I wouldn't be shocked if they brought in Edward to do Vogue US. I mean, he's doing all these really diverse covers. He understands that people are looking for diversity and inclusivity, and he's the one that's putting it out. The Vogue covers in the US are quite awful and boring. So it's smart, and they're really giving the people what they want. I think it's the obvious choice that Edward would go from British Vogue to American Vogue. That is actually what happened with Anna. She was actually at British Vogue while Grace Mirabella was there, and then Grace Mirabella got ousted, and they brought in Anna. And I think that was always the plan that they always wanted to do. So I think that's kind of what is happening here. I also think that somebody like Katie Grand, who runs Love Magazine, will take over the British Vogue editor-in-chiefness. It allows her to do both magazines, and it'll be a step up for her in her career, so I think that they've all thought it out very well. Longtime Condé chairman Cy Newhouse, who died in October 2017, was Wintour's biggest cheerleader, but there are rumors that his presumed successor Jonathan Newhouse, who is chairman of Condé Nast International and has been in London running the company's international arm, is coming back to New York. Jonathan, quotation marks, doesn't like the amount of power Anna has, and favors Enninful, one source tells us. I mean, that makes a lot of sense. You would want somebody that you can control. And Anna does have a lot of power. She is well known. She is known just in general. She is a very powerful figure. So if you want to control the company and you want to do what you want to do as a new person coming in, to oversee all of these publications, you would want the old guard to kind of leave. Reps for Condé Nast declined to comment on Jonathan Newhouse and pointed us to reps for their international arm, which didn't immediately comment. Other insiders tell Page Six that consultants are currently in the Condé offices reviewing the firm's finances to identify how the company moves forward in the current media climate, identifying cuts and changes. But they insist this is a regular yearly process. The news comes as Condé struggles amid a shift in the publishing industry. Under Wintour's watch as artistic director, Condé has closed the print editions of Teen Vogue, Self, and Details. They also forgot Lucky Mag as well, which Ava Chen used to be in charge of. And it has fought to compete online after closing down Style.com. What a shame that Style.com got literally destroyed. Now Vogue Runway is the new Style.com. Sources told the Post that the company is about $100 million a year in red ink, which I assume means that they're losing about $100 million every year in terms of their finances, which is not good, especially for an industry like publishing now that is quite fickle. And while many fashion insiders say that Vogue without Wintour is unimaginable, other Condé Nast grandees have been toppling left and right. Within the last year, Graydon Carter, who presided over Vanity Fair for 25 years, was replaced by Radhika Jones, and Cindy Leave, who oversaw Glamour for 16 years, was traded out for digital guru Samantha Barry. Meanwhile, Linda Wells was ousted from Allure in 2015 after 14 years and replaced by 42-year-old Michelle Lee. Also, you had Amy Astley, who was running Teen Vogue, was kind of yanked away from it and put into Architectural Digest. Anna, I'm pretty positive from what I can see, doesn't want any people that she has kind of groomed, girls like Eva Chen and Amy Astley, looking bad because it looks bad on her. And that's why I think that she put in Elaine Welteroth and Philip Picardi at Teen Vogue. She doesn't really know them all that much, and she just kind of wanted to make it look like a diverse kind of change up that people would buy into. But well-connected Wintour won't be short of other offers. She may be eyeing a big fashion position back in England, such as leading the British Fashion Council, which in reflection makes her front row seat next to Queen Elizabeth II at London Fashion Week in February an incredibly effective personal PR move. Currently, Sarah Moore heads up the British Fashion Council, but I'm pretty positive Sarah Moore also works for British Vogue, so it'd be easy to kind of give her the chop. Also, Anna would not stop working. Same way that Grace Coddington hasn't when she left Vogue, she probably would continue to contribute to different things or just be in general working and making moves within the fashion industry. It was previously reported Wintour had hoped to land an ambassadorial position in London had her friend Hillary Clinton won the presidency. There's even buzz that Wintour's exit interview has already been arranged and granted to the New York Times, the newspaper that also smoothed over the edges of Carter and Leave's departures, insisting that both had left entirely of their own volition. The Grey Lady's headline for Leave was How to Quit a Magazine by Cindy Leave. Let me just say, I have a lot of respect for Anna Wintour. I think she is brilliant. I know on this channel I've said, like, oh, I hate what she does. I hate, like, the Vogue covers. But she's done the best with what she can in the current publishing climate. And honestly, she was a revolutionary publisher who put fashion on the map. Anna is brilliant, and I think I would lose a lot more respect if she kind of went down with the ship. She knows that her reputation is set. The September issue, the first Monday in May, like, those movies made her. The covers that she put out made her. Like, if she were to stay, it would ruin her reputation. The magazines would go down while she was leading the ship and leading the publishing industry. I know that the captain is supposed to go down with the ship, but in this case, Anna has done so much for fashion. She has literally turned the industry on its head in the most positive way. And she deserves the respect and ability to leave when she's leaving. She has done everything she can to kind of try and make it happen, but I don't think that she can turn the tides. I don't think she knows what's happening. So leave it to the younger people like Edward Enninful and Philip Picardi, and just let them do it. Let them handle it. They need to be able to do something about it and change the industry. As I said earlier, fashion rumors usually are true. As much as fashion brands and fashion companies want to deny the rumors, they usually happen. I mean, look at every single fashion rumor that has been going on. Virgil Abloh going to Louis Vuitton, Phoebe Philo leaving Celine. Like, it just happens. So I don't see it as something that is unimaginable. Like, I think it will happen in the future. please let me know what you guys think of Anna leaving Vogue. Will it just like literally ruin your lives? Will you never ever look at another fashion magazine ever again? Or are you just like so happy that she's gone and you literally will do 1400 shots while watching the September issue? Tell me in the comments. I will see you guys in the next video. Thank you so much for watching. So, TTYL.